Hello. Today we'll talk about one of our new products, which is BAICALIN-PLUS. So this product was recently introduced to the arsenal of gluten-free remedies. So BAICALIN-PLUS is a blend of baicalin from Chinese skullcap, L-theanine, and NIGELLA sativa or black cumin seed extract. We designed the product primarily as a natural remedy to control anxiety. However, BAICALIN-PLUS can be also used as a part of antimicrobial protocols, and we'll cover some of these topics today. So baicalin is a flavonoid which is purified from the plant Scutellaria baicalensis or skullcap. It's well recognized that baicalin is the main medicinal component of the plant. Its highest concentration found in the root of skullcap. Skullcap or Scutellaria baicalensis has been used for thousands of years in traditional Chinese medicine to treat inflammation, fever, jaundice, and hypertension. So this is basically an illustrative slide. It shows the plant, Scutellaria baicalensis, the dried root. And also right here, you can see a hand-drawn figure from Compendium of Materia Medica by Li Shizhen from medieval time. So again, it's a plant which is well recognized in Chinese medicine as very useful in a number of human diseases. So baicalin is used right now more and more for neuroprotection. How does it work? So first of all, baicalin is a positive allosteric modulator of the benzodiazepine site or a non-benzodiazepine site of the GABA alpha 1 receptor. It's very obvious that in animals and humans, baicalin, because of that property, produces very strong anti-anxiety effect without any sedation or muscle relaxation. Another very important property is that baicalin regulates dopamine synthesis and dopamine release and increases dopamine levels in the striatum. So baicalin penetrates through blood-brain barrier, and again, it shows very strong neuroprotective and synaptoprotective effect on dopaminergic neurons. Because of that, baicalin can be used to treat dopamine dysfunction-associated diseases such as Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, and attention deficit disorder. So, as I mentioned a few minutes ago, baicalin also expresses broad-spectrum antimicrobial and antiviral activities. In clinical practice, baicalin can be used as an adjunct therapy and sometimes actually as a solo therapy to treat Bartonella hanseli and other species of Bartonella, Borrelia burgdorferi, Helicobacter pylori, Clostridium difficile, various species of Staphylococcus, various species of Mycoplasma, Pseudomonas, Mycobacteria. It also has antiviral activity against influenza A, hepatitis A, B, and C, and herpes simplex type 1 and 2. Also, baicalin not only has antimicrobial or antiviral activity, it also pretty strong anti-inflammatory product. And to some extent, it protects organs affected by infectious agents by lowering the amount of inflammatory responses. So this is mainly a kind of basic science slide. It talks about how baicalin works as an anti-inflammatory or immunomodulating remedies. So basically, it affects various immune cell types, such as lymphocytes, macrophages, mast cells, dendritic cells, monocytes, and neutrophils. It inhibits production of inflammatory cytokines, including IL-1 beta, IL-6, IL-8, and TNF-alpha, and other inflammatory mediators such as nitric oxide, prostaglandins, leukotrienes, and ROS. And there are several pathways which are affected by baicalin, which have been identified within the last couple of years. Again, this slide mainly for educational purposes. It basically describes how baicalin modulates anti-inflammatory responses. So less known indications for baicalin therapy, nevertheless, not less important, are pancreatitis, non-alcoholic fatty liver, or NASH, gout, pulmonary fibrosis, diabetes, and colitis. And the activity of baicalin in these human conditions been described in peer-reviewed magazines. So the second component of baicalin plus is L-theanine, which is known for quite a few people because it's available as a supplement by itself. So L-theanine, also known as L-glutamyl ethylamide, is amino acid analog of amino acids L-glutamide and L-glutamine. And it's found primarily in plant and various fungal species. It was discovered in 1949 as a constituent of green tea, and it was isolated from guaiacura leaves. L-theanine provides a unique brothy or savory, so-called umami, flavor to green tea infusions. Again, L-theanine is structurally very similar to the excitatory neurotransmitter glutamate, and it binds the glutamate receptor. And basically, it mediates its activity through glutamate receptor, and to a less extent, NMDA receptor. Also, L-theanine inhibits glutamine transporters and glutamate transporters, and blocks the reuptake of glutamine and glutamate. And again, for those who want to know how it works for the umami taste, it binds through T1R1 and T1R3 heterodimer taste receptor. So what's been shown also that L-theanine increases serotonin, dopamine, and glycine levels in various areas of the brain. It also increases production of brain-derived neurotrophic factor and NGF, a nerve growth factor, in certain brain areas. However, its effect on serotonin is still a matter of debate in the community, and again, we're not going to talk much about that. So also, there's some speculation that L-theanine may inhibit glutamate excitotoxicity. So the last component of our product is an extract from Nigella sativa, also known as black cumin seeds. So it's a plant which is widely used for various medical purposes all over the world. And seeds and oil, which is black seed oil, have a long history in various parts of the world as part of traditional folklore medicine. So the seeds of Nigella sativa have been used widely to treat hypertension, various liver diseases, as well as diuretics, digestive, antidiarrheal, appetite stimulant, pain relieving, and antimicrobial products. So again, our product is primarily designed to treat anxiety, and extracts from Nigella sativa seeds are known to possess a very strong anxiolytic or anti-anxiety activity. So the mechanism of this product is based on the fact that it increases 5-HT or 5-hydroxytryptophan and decreasing 5-hydroxyindole acetic acid level in the brain. So long-term use of Nigella sativa extract increases 5-HT level in the brain and improve learning and memory in animals. So again, the anti-anxiety effects of Nigella sativa were demonstrated in both humans and animals. So therefore, in our product, we combine three main plant products with anti-anxiety activities, such as baicalin, L-theanine, and nigella sativa. And we do see a very strong anti-anxiety effect of the product in our clinical practice. So Baicalin Plus can be combined with other nutraceuticals to treat anxiety. So I put together several combinations which we are using in our clinic. The most popular combination is Baicalin Plus plus lithium orotate. So we're also using Baicalin Plus combined with CBD and GABA, Baicalin Plus plus agmatine. Also, we found that there were some differences in pharmacokinetics between encapsulated solid extract and liquid extract, and therefore, in certain situations, we're using Baicalin Plus, which is a solid extract, as well as a liquid analog, which is a tincture containing Chinese skullcap and also silk tree extract. And finally, it's a very popular combo in patients who have Bartonella-induced anxiety. We're using Baicalin Plus and Maya Inositol, and this combination works actually extremely well for patients with Bartonella-associated anxiety. As I mentioned earlier, Baicalin Plus has antimicrobial activity, and in our practice, we're using it also as a part of complex therapy for Lyme disease or other tick-borne infections, and to treat bartonellosis in particular. So these are common combinations which are used in our practice. So Baicalin plus Catsclaw plus Atoba plus Lamation tincture is probably number one. Baicalin plus with combined with Maya Inositol plus Black Walnut tincture. Baicalin plus another product, unique product in our practice, Barton tincture and vanadyl sulfate. And finally, it's a Baicalin plus Campisandra plus Bromelain plus NAC. And we do have a Bromelain combined with NAC in one capsule. So it's a combo product. So the list is obviously not complete, but these are most common products which we're using in our practice. So I also decided to put more or less educational slide about Baicalin and drug interactions. On the left side, you can see a wide range of pharmaceutical drugs which potentially can interact with Baicalin, because Baicalin can affect various pharmacokinetic properties of these drugs. So just be aware when your patient's taking some of these drugs to check their blood level. What is also interesting that Baicalin can increase potency of certain anti-cancer drugs, anti-diabetic drugs, obviously antimicrobial drugs, and for example, in our practice, we're quite frequently using doxycycline combined with Baicalin as a mainstream therapy for Bartonella. And also it can enhance, obviously, therapeutic efficacy of drugs for Parkinson, epilepsy, and inflammation. So what are the potential side effects? The side effects are not very common. They're very rare. So, but they do include, once in a while, we see like hyperglycemia, transient elevation of liver enzymes, palpitations, and sometimes insomnia. So thank you. If you have any questions, please contact Gluten-Free Remedies. We'll be more than happy to answer on most of your questions. Thank you.